Hello, Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism, and presentation of this John's baptism in water has given you a good glimpse into the powers of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. There are two types of spirit, spirit of man and spirit of God. Holy Spirit with small s is the spirit of man, which is common sense, and which I have exercised to dig out the truth, which the people had hidden it. The Jewish people had hidden it, and so are the people in India, these of the second anointed Christ, Nanak, they have hidden it too. But through the Holy Spirit, we call it Surti in Punjabi. Surti means the same thing as Holy Spirit. You can dig out treasures. So when you use exercise Holy Spirit or common sense, it shatters the fetters of the letters. That means what is written in the book, it shatters their all those books away. That means then you are overriding the books, not the books are overriding you. So in the Jerusalem, the books were overriding those Jews, not the spirit or the common sense. So on Sabbath, Jesus was healing people which is devoted to God, in which you do philanthropic work, and those who are devoid of the Holy Spirit, they were objecting, hey, why are you doing it? So on which other day is to be celebrated best by doing philanthropic work than Sabbath? So such is the dryness of spirit among the Jews, whereas the Gentile, they never mind whether it is Sabbath or not, they always helped people as he helped the Samaritan man picked up the wounded person. So they were there for them, every day was Sabbath to perform philanthropic work. That's why St. Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. So it is through this Holy Spirit, common sense, I have told you many things which are easy to understand, because these are the things of John the Baptist which you can see with your two naked eyes. That's why St. Thomas said, first know what you see with your two naked eyes, then what is not seen of God, you understand by the third eye of logical reasoning, would be known to you. But if you cannot understand these things, you know, what you see with the true naked eye, then you can't understand the gospel. So gospel is for the sensible people. And these people who tell you that in the churches and other places, that gospel is for everyone, that they are antichrist. Antichrist feed you sugar-coated tablets, as the temple priest in Israel, they were making Jews of the physical body of ritual. And they will say everybody could be a Jew and everybody could be this and that. So they were not producing Jews of the spirit. The result is well known in people like Saul, who being not of spirit, as he was told, he was doing it. But he in his heart knew that what he is doing is wrong. That's why I said his conscience did not allow him to do, but his body did it. So there are many people among you whose conscience hits when you do something wrong, but you do it to please the temple priest or to your bishop and to pope and other thing. All these popes and other things, they are antichrist, and so are these dog-collared people. Dog-collared people, they are working for Mammon. Challenge them, ask them, are you working for Mammon or for God? And they will hypocritically pretend that they are working for God. If they are working for God, then God should pay them the money in gospel currency. Gospel currency, treasures, which are never rust, nobody can steal, and they rest where your heart is. Whereas this moment they get these priest dollars, they get pension, they get everything, and they are like secular jobs, performing secular jobs, and they are working for Mammon, and their masters are the church elders. He cannot say something which is the church elders don't like. They are not free men. Whereas people like me and others who preach gospel, we are not paid in Mammon. We are paid by our Father, God. And we are free men, that Jesus has set us free. So we are not slave to Mammon. We do not go by what people say or what the bishop say or this and that, but what our Holy Spirit directs us to. We go by our Holy Spirit, the companion which Jesus has left us. This is the age when you have to give your own account to God, and you can give your own account to God when you exercise Holy Spirit, common sense. Nobody can give your account to God. This everybody knows. Then what the hell these bishops and these popes putting on dog collar are doing? Where do they stand? They are antichrist. Point finger at them and tell them, tell me where you stand between man and God, because when Jesus died, the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn apart, telling people to have direct approach to God through his word. So ask them where they stand between man and God, because our teacher is God and Holy Spirit is our mother. Sorry, our teacher is a Holy Spirit, our mother, and we are daughters of Holy Spirit, virgin, and we have Christ in our heart. There is no greater than Christ. So why should we go by these priests, dog-collared priests? Who the hell they are? They have no place to in Christianity. They are anti-Christ. And they will feed you with sugar-coated tablets. They will tell you that baptism of John in water, if you do not take it, you will go to hell. This and that, there is no hell in Jesus. No heaven in Jesus. It is salvation in Jesus. It is by grace. So you create your own hell and heaven by living. If you live in the righteousness of God, then you are living in peace among your neighbors. But if you are a crook and you cheat other people, then you are creating problem, trouble, and people will kill you as they killed Jewish people in Germany and other countries. So go by your spirit and see what I have found, and you too can find it. So if you find something, then preach on the lampstand. Put that light on lampstand. Don't put it under the bushel. Don't be frightened of anyone. These dog-collared priests, they will call you heretic, as they call me in Reading. I have been called heretic by quite a few of these dog-collared priests, but I call them antichrist, dog-collared, hirelings of Mammon. Not working for God, but working for Mammon. So please, please exercise Holy Spirit and preach gospel, and God give you